Hello student, now today we will start with your 12th class mathematics and CBSE course, and the first chapter is relations and functions. Relations and functions. Relation and function. In your last class, we have already discussed about the many things related to. First of all, I was discussing about set. After then, I discussed with you about how many types of set, universal set, and I was telling you about the how can you make a relation and what is the function. I have already introduced about the relation and function. But in your 11th class chapter, there was some we did not read out about the, we read only about the sets and how many sets and how can we create a sets and relation. But in 12th class, we will read how many types of relations and we will solve many examples to related the set relation. And after then relation completion, we will read out about the functions and what is the function, how many types function you have already. I will discuss in your 11th class, previous class functions group. But before, I am just talking about the relation. Now, I will tell you the how many topics we will discuss in this class. The today discussion will be, I am telling you, today discussion about the types of relation. Because I have already tell you that relation, what is the relation? This in previous class, because this is the day 2 of a relation and function class. In your day 1, what I was telling you about the relation, suppose that in your family, in daily routine life, you are facing many relations. Means someone may be your father, someone may be your mother, and brother, sister, cousin, sister, grandfather, granddaughter. But this is a way how to represent in a mathematically form. Suppose that I want to say that A is brother of B, and A and B means belonging to R. R means a family, if you want to can say that R belong to a family that R belonging to, because I have already discovered the what is the notations of belonging. That notation of belonging, this is the F, this one sign, and not belonging sign is this one, and these are the Greek words. These are the Greek words. Then just I want to say, please write this one relation in a mathematically form. That what you will write, that A and B both are the members of family R. Means A and B belonging to R, and A is brother of B. Then what you will write, a brother of B means, just I am taking its notation into, A is brother of B. And such that after then you will write here that A is brother of B. Means this is a representation in a mathematical form to represent a relation. That this was, we have already discussed about this, that I will not go further again. That's why just I will tell you about the types of relation. Types of relation. This is the same kind of thing, means what I am trying to say, that same means in your family, a grandfather is here, a grandmother is also there. In same case, types of relation, there are many types of relation. First of all, we will discuss about a phi relation. Phi relation. Phi relation means a empty relation. Phi means represent a empty relation. Empty relation. Then what is the definition of empty relation? I am telling you that A is a subset of A into A. A is a subset of A into A. A into A, what is representing here? A into A representing the relation between what is there. And A is subset, that I have already tell you about the subset, what is subset. And thus, the empty set phi and A into A are two extreme relations. What is this? Extreme relations. What are these extreme relations? Extreme relation. I am giving you a example, after then I will write a definition. Suppose that R is a relation and A and B, what are A? A and B are the family members of, means are A and B belonging to, where relation is given A minus B is equals to 10. A minus B is equals to 10. And what is here A? A, where A is 1, 2, 3 and 4, and A and B belonging to A. Now you can understand, this is, suppose that this is a quotient. How will you really understand what is a phi relation and what is a, how many types we can say? Tell me. First of all, there are four objects given here, because you know this. So first of all, please tell me, A is given in a roster form, yes, set builder form. Yes, A is given in a roster form. And A and B, two components are given here, A and B, or both are belonging to A. Means A value may be 1, 2, 3, 4 and B value may be 1, 2, 3, 4. And what is the relation is given here? Means A minus B is equals to 10. Please tell me, if I am writing here, A value is also 1, because of there is no any relation is given here, any further information that A not be equal B, is this is not given. So that's why I'm saying A may be 1. First of all, I'm taking the case 1, A is equals to 1 and B is equals to also 1. Then tell me, A minus 1, then if you are writing 1 minus 1, then 1 minus 1 you will get 0. And 0 is equals to 10? No, it's not equals to 10. Understood? 0 is not equals to 10. Suppose that in same case, if A is equals to will be B, then 2 and 2, 3 and 3, 4 and 4, that means what you will get? Then you will get, it will be not become any subset of this. Second condition hai, suppose that I am taking A is 1 and B is 2, then you will get 1 minus 2. 1 minus 2, suppose that, then what will you get? Minus 1. And minus 1 does not belong to what? Minus 1 is not equals to 10. Minus 1 is not equals to 10, means it's, this is not following this relation. In same manner, if you want to take A value minimum is 1 and B value is maximum 4. If you will take A value is 4, B value is 1, then 4 minus 1, of course 3. That A, B belonging to, of course you are getting the component is belonging to A, but A minus B means 3 Can we write 3 is equals to 10? No, we cannot write 3 is equals to 10. You can understand 3 cannot be equal 10. What means there we are not getting any subset of relation which is following the a minus b is equals to 10. Then what is the is like this extreme relation, what you will be say, this relation called be a empty relation where we are not getting any subset. Understood? I think you can understand that what I am trying to say. So now I will write here the definition of empty set. Definition of empty set. If you want to know, because of all these are necessary points to solve the relations and functions type questions. Because this question, if you are writing, you can understand this question, but the way of to write a relation and a function, these are so necessary points. That's why, so note down, if you want to note down, then you can note down in your notebook. And please remember all these things. What is the relation definition of empty set? That a relation we represent a R in a set. Set is given means this capital A means a starting of a sentence, but a set of set name is A. Set name is A is called empty set. Sorry. A empty relation if no element of A is related to any element of A, means that is R is equals to phi subset of A into A. Now you can understand this is the definition of empty set. Because that last previous example, then there was given relation A minus B is equals to 10. And A and B belonging to capital A, or A set is given 1, 2, 3 and 4. Then you will see if we are taking the higher component of A, that is 4, and minimum component of B, that is 1. Then 4 minus 1 is equals to 3. 3 is equals to 10. This is incorrect. 3 is equals to 10. It can never be. We can write 3 is equals to 10. So this type of relation we say empty relation. So you can understand a relation R in a set. A is called empty relation if no element of A is related to any element of A. That is R is equals to, how can you represent it? That R is equals to phi, a subset of A into A is A into A. Suppose that now this one was the first type. This is the first type of relation. Now, second type of relation we will discuss. Now I'm giving also even example more. Yes. Suppose that function R is given A, B, and what is such that mod of A minus B is greater than is equal to 0. Greater than is equal to 0. And where A and B belonging to capital A, and A, capital A is given here 1, 2, 3 and 4. 1, 2, 3 and 4. Now please tell me that it is satisfying, no. Yes, because you can see here, if you are writing A value is 1, suppose that, because A and B both are belonging to capital A, capital A, there are components are given 1, 2, 3 and 4. First of all, I am taking A, B, A value and B value are the same. Suppose that 1, that values are same. Then what you will see here, what is relation given here? Mod of A minus B. That A minus B, so if we are taking same values, suppose that 1 minus 1, suppose that 2 minus 2, suppose that 3 minus 3, suppose that 4 minus 4, because already 4 components are given here, that I am taking here, last digit 4. Then 1 minus 1, what you will get? You will get 0. Here, you will get 0, 0 and 0. Or you can see in your relation that mod of A minus B is greater than, but there is also given a sign equal to 0. Means this is fully completely following this one relation. This one is fully and completely following this relation. Okay, this one was a first time. Now you can make what subsets we are making. That A value and B value are 1, means 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3 and 4, 4. Now, just I am taking that A and B values are different. A and B are different. Okay. Suppose that A I am taking here 1 and B I am taking 2. Then what you will get? A minus B, that 1 minus 2. 1 minus 2. Then you will get minus 1. If, suppose that, if we did not get here the sign, mode sign, if we did not get mode sign, then what you will see? That negative 1, and negative 1 is greater than equals to 0? Never. It is less than equals to 0. But there is given sign mod. Mod sign, what will we do here? It will be negative sign will be make a positive. Then what will we get? 1 is greater than is equal to 0. 1 is greater than is equal to 0. Means this concept is following the relation. This concept is following the relation. Means if you are getting, if you are taking the A value is less than B value, means if you are supposing A value is less than B value, then you can satisfy this relation. In same manner, if you are taking B value is greater than A, B value is greater than A, that is also because you will find the positive, and positive is always greater than is equal to 0. Now you can see here how many ways then you are taking the components 1, 1, 2, 2, same manner, A is greater than B and B is greater than A. This, these all type of sets, these all types of set are following this relation. This type of relation we say a universal relation. That is completely following this concept. That is completely following this same concept. Then what will we make a definition? I am writing here. This type of set we say universal relation, that definition is a relation car is a set A is called a universal relation. Okay, this one, a relation R is set A called a universal relation. And what are the properties of relation? If each element you can understand, suppose that a set was given here 1 2 3 4, means 1 2 3 and 4, the four components or four elements are what? Each elements of A is related to every element of A. That is that R is equals to A into A. How many elements will be there? That every element will be make a relation with every element, means A into A. How many elements are there? Four elements are there. That one relation make it one, two relation make it two, three relation make with three, four make relation four, one make relation two, one two three, one four, two three, two, and so on. Means every element will be make a relation to each element of A. This is the definition of universal relation. Okay, student. These we have already read out the two types of relation. First was empty, second was universal relation. Now, in your 12th class standard, we will read out the many types of relation, but these are the basic relations. We will start with a new relation. What is this relation? If both the empty relation and the universal relation are sometimes called trivial relation. If any relation is following, what is the both the empty set, empty relation and the universal relation are sometimes, kahi means you can understand, sometimes some places that these called are the trivial relation. If you get there some in any question that please this given cell set, yeah, this relation is given, this is a trivial relation, that you can understand this is following the both property, different property, empty set for empty relation property and also universal relation property. Means I am writing again here, this is a very important point that I am making note here. Important, what is both the both the which one? Both means empty and universal. Empty and the universal relation are sometimes called the trivial relation. Now you can understand this is a very important point. Suppose that in any question given, this is the tribal relation that you can understand. This is the following the both property, that the empty relation and universal relation. Now, we will read a new relation. What is relation? After then, I will tell you about this definition. 3. Definition 3. A relation R is said to be is said to be called, first is reflexive. If reflexive, second, symmetry, and third is transitive. And what are the properties of this type of relation? Reflexive, symmetric, and transitive. I will tell you a one thing. Reflexive. If A and A means both A and A belonging to R, for every small a is belonging to capital A. It means suppose that A is given here, what is capital A is given here, 1, 2, 3 and 4. Then reflexive relation what will be? A and A means same number, that A belonging to capital A, that A may be 1, 2, 3 and 4. But what type of relation? 1, 1. Pair of 1, 1. Pair of 2, 2. Pair of 3, 3. Pair of 4, 4. Only these type means 4 subset you can get A and A. If any subset, if any relation is following this type of property, that call be a reflexive relation. That call be a reflexive relation. Otherwise, if suppose that you can see here 1 and 2, 2 and 3, and 3 and 4. If any this type of subsets you are getting in your relation, this is following this property? No, because of suppose that A is this one, A is here one, that this is not A. This is not A. This is anything else. Means A and A, same things will be repeat itself. It call be a reflexive relation. It call be a reflexive relation. Otherwise, if you are not getting 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, that it cannot be represented a reflexive relation. And second type, symmetric. And what is the property for symmetric relation? Symmetric relation. A relation is said to be a symmetric relation if A1 and A2 belonging to R, implies that A2 and A1 belonging to R, where for all A1 and A2 are belonging to capital A. Means you can understand what is, suppose that A is given here, what? Same case, 1, 2, 3 and 4. A1 and A2, here is not representing that what is, suppose the relation we are taking, say A minus B, mod of A minus B is greater than its cost to 0. Okay, suppose that I am taking here this one. We will see that this is following this property, symmetric relation, or no. Then what we will see, A1 and A2, A1 and 2 components I am taking here, suppose that this may be that A1 minus A2 is greater than its cost to 0. Then A1 may be 0, 0. Yes, 0, 0. But I am taking the in different case. What is, both are different. That A1 is 1 and A2 is 2. A2 is 2. Then what you will see, that 1 minus 2, then you will get 1. You will get 1. And in same case, if A2 is equals to 1 and A1 is first, A2 is equals to 1 and A1 is equals to 2, then what you will get? That 2 minus 1, then you are getting 1. Means subset of A1, A2 is, and A2, A1 is belonging to this one concept, belonging to A. And you can see A1, A2 belonging to R, and also A2, A1 is belonging to R. This type of relation can be say a symmetric relation. Asymmetric relation. If there is no change, matlab, if we are changing the A1 and A2 values, but the relation is following itself, means given here, mod of A1 minus A2 is given is greater than is equal to 0. That is following this property. If we are changing A2 A1 with A1 to A2, that is nothing is happening, and it is following this concept. This type of relation we will say symmetric relation. A symmetric relation. Now we will read transitive relation. Third one. If A1 and A2 belonging to R and A2, A3 is also belonging to R, that implies that A1 and A3 will be belonging to R for all what, that A1, A2 and A3, all three components are belonging to capital A. This is the property of transitive relation. Suppose that A1, A2 belonging to R, and also A2 and A3 are belonging to R, that their relation A1 to A3 must be implies in their relation. That type of relation we will say transitive relation. This type of say we will say transitive relation. And this type of relation means number fourth definition we will read. Number fourth, a relation R. A relation R in set A is said to be an equivalence. Which one? Equivalence. EQUI. VALANCE, equivalence relation. If We will say a relation in set A is said to be in an equivalent relation if what property must be, if R is reflexive and symmetric. And transitive. Now you can understand. Suppose that how many types questions can be asked. First number we read out about the empty set, empty relation. Second time we read universal relation. Third time we read out which one? Reflexive, symmetric and transitive. But if any relation is following all these three properties, reflexive, symmetric and transitive, this type of set we say a set of relation, we will say an equivalence relation. Means how can we represent a quotient? Means a quotient, how will we attempt? Please tell me, suppose that this one function is given R, T1 and T2 and T3. This is a equivalence relation. Means you have to prove that all three property to related this relation means first of all you should represent reflexive, after then you will symmetric and after then transitive. If any relation is not following one property, suppose that it is following reflexive and not following the two properties symmetric and transitive, that this type of set we cannot say an equivalence relation. If any relation is following the three properties, reflexive also, symmetric also and transitive also, that will be or can, that will be an equivalence relation. Okay student, you and now I think you can understand what is this, and I will tell you, I will give you one example that will be more sufficient to understand the relative, reflexive and transitive and symmetrical relations. This one question is lower CBSC 12th class example number 2. Given the what is the question is given here, that let T be the set of some problem is happening. Let them set of all triangles in a plane with R a relation T in T is given by what is that R is equals to T1, T2. R is given T1, T2. Where what is T1? T1 is congruent T2. That what is saying, show that R is equivalence relation. Equivalence relation. First of all, where what is given here, we will understand the question, after then we will solve it. Let the set of all triangles in a plane, let the set of all triangles in a plane with R a relation in t given by r is equals to t1 t2. T1 t2, where t1 is congruent t2, where t1 is congruent to t2, show that r is an equivalence relation. Okay, first of all we will understand congruent. You know about the congruent? Because if you will not understand what is the congruent, then how you will understand it is the following the properties of equivalent relation? Yes, then I will tell you what is the congruent means. congruent triangles, we will say if two triangles, suppose given here, okay, two triangles is given here and I am also given their name. This one is t2, t1, and this is t2. And this is P, Q and R. This is A, B and C. If PQ length is same is AB, 4. PR is given 5 and it is also 5. And it is 3, then it is 3. In same manner means if this type of relation is given in two triangles, this type of triangles each other means if two triangles are congruent, if and on if their corresponding parts are congruent. If corresponding parts are congruent means this one side is equal to this one side is equal to this one side, and this one side is equal to this one side. These type of triangles we say equivalence triangle. Okay, now you can understand what is the equivalence triangles. Now we will read it further. The what is saying that t1 is congruent t2 means I just representing here t1 is represent congruent to t2, so that r is an equivalence relation, so that r is a equivalence relation. Now for proving the equivalence relation, what property it must be satisfy? Number one, it must be reflexive. Number first reflexive. Number two, symmetric. Number three, transitive. Now, R is reflexive, yes or no? Because every triangle is congruent to itself. Every triangle is congruent to itself. This is the property of a triangle. So, I will not clear it. That's why that every triangle is congruent itself. Means this one property is following which one concept? First number, reflexive. Okay, now your first property is satisfied. Now we will go further. What is second one? Is symmetric. Symmetric property, what the symmetric property say? If A1, A2 is belonging to, is A1, A2 is belonging to R, those then A2, A1 is also belonging to R. If this type of property is following, so that will be a congruent and that will be a symmetric relation. And what you are understanding, I am saying T1 and T2 both are congruent, of course belonging to R is congruent. Yes or no? It is congruent. But please tell me, can I write here no that T2 and T1, T2 and T1 is belonging to R and it is congruent to T2? Means this I am reading out it. T1 is congruent to T2, that in the same manner I can say T2 is congruent to T10 P1, yes and no? Of course I can say, because this type of triangle is given here. This is 3, 4 and 5. The same 3, 4 and 5. If I am saying that triangle PQR, that PR is same in this one, A, B, C, AC. And again I am saying that AC is equal to PR. Then what is the meaning of that? I can write AC is equal to PR and I can write PR is equal to AC. Yes and no. Then what is the benefit? Means I can write in this manner. T1 is T2 belonging to R and T1 is congruent to T2. In same manner, T2 and T1, because if we are changing these type, because if in same case, suppose that A minus B mode is happening. If there is no mode, means the A minus B, wait. Suppose that given here A minus B, same case which have already 1, 2, 3 and 4. A value is belonging to 1, 2, 3 and 4. Suppose that here is given A minus B. If A is greater than B, then we will get the positive value. But if B is greater than A, we will get negative value. So that in case we cannot write what A minus B, that 1 and 2. Which one value we are getting 1 and 2, then we are not getting 2 and 1. Because A1, A2 values we are changing is second one. A1 and A2 values we are changing. But after the changing A1 and A2 value, we are getting the different values. In this case, we cannot say this is the symmetric. But if we are saying that T1 is congruent to T2, then we can say T2 is congruent to T1. That in this case, we can say that T1 and T2 is following the symmetric relation. Now you can understand that how can we represent the symmetric relation in this case. I am writing here that T1, T2 is belonging to R. Is belonging to R means T1 is congruent to T2, implies that we are saying that T2 is congruent to T1, and what is in a T1 in the same manner that T2, T1 belonging to R. This is the way of represent in a symmetric case. Now two properties we have satisfied for the in an equivalence relation. Now what is the third property say? Third property, what will we say? In what is saying? Now I am taking the three triangles. Okay. For the three triangles. Which one? The T1. P, Q and R. Second one, A, B and C. Third one is S, U, V. Okay, S, U, V. Why it is not S, U, V? This is 3, this is 4, this is 5, this is 3, this is 4, this is 5, this is 3, this is 4 and this is 5. If T1 and T2 are congruent to each other, that T2 and T3 are congruent to each other, that I can say that T1 and T3 is also a congruent to each other. Then you can understand that what is the representation? T1, T2, T2, T3 are belonging to R exactly, and T1 is congruent to T2, yes, and T2 is congruent to T3. In same manner, the T3 will be congruent to T1. This is the representation of this one. Then what will we say? Then we will say that T1 T2 and T3. Yes, that T1, T2 belonging to R, T2, T3 belonging to R. Yes. So, Vita, we are saying T1 is congruent to T2 and T2 is congruent to T3. Then what we will say that T3 will be congruent to T1. That R is an equivalence, that R is an equivalence relation because of it is following all the properties. Following the three properties